The vast expanse of the sky, once an unchallenged domain, is now the realm of sophisticated machines flown by highly skilled pilots. These are not mere airplanes, they are instruments of national defense, each precisely engineered for specific tasks. Two branches of the military, the Navy and the Air Force, command impressive fleets of aircraft, each tailored to their unique operational doctrines. While both Navy and Air Force aircraft share the common goal of defending the nation, their roles, operating environments, and design philosophies are strikingly different. The Navy, with its focus on sea control and power projection, requires aircraft capable of operating from the decks of aircraft carriers, far from traditional air bases. The Air Force, on the other hand, specializes in land-based operations, providing air superiority, strategic bombing, and close air support to ground troops. These divergent missions necessitate distinct aircraft designs and pilot training regimens. A Navy fighter jet built for carrier landings will differ significantly from its Air Force counterpart, optimized for long-range strikes from concrete runways. This essay will delve into the key differences between Navy and Air Force aircraft, exploring their operational roles, design features, and the unique challenges faced by the pilots who fly them. The Navy and the Air Force operate in vastly different environments, dictating the design and capabilities of their aircraft. Navy aircraft, deployed on aircraft carriers, are constantly at sea, facing the corrosive effects of salt water and the ever-present risk of turbulent weather. Takeoffs and landings conducted on the relatively short decks of carriers are inherently more challenging and dangerous than those performed on the spacious runways of land-based airbases. Air Force aircraft, in contrast, enjoy the relative comfort and stability of land-based operations. They have the luxury of longer runways, sophisticated maintenance facilities, and access to a wider array of support infrastructure. This allows for heavier payloads, longer range, and specialized equipment not feasible for their carrier-based counterparts. The unforgiving maritime environment demands that Navy aircraft be highly robust, corrosion-resistant, and capable of withstanding the rigors of carrier operations. Folding wings designed to maximize space on crowded carrier decks are a common feature, as are reinforced landing gear systems built to withstand the impact of arrested landings. Air Force aircraft, while still subject to demanding conditions, have the luxury of being designed for optimal performance within the Earth's atmosphere, rather than the constraints of a floating airbase. GAP 3S. Due to these differences between naval and Air Force aircraft, the same aircraft model is produced as different submodels for the Air Force version and the naval version. For example, the FA-18 Hornet has both a naval version used by the Navy and a land-based version used by the Air Force. Another example is the F-35 Lightning II, which has the F-35A for the Air Force and the F-35C for the Navy. GAP 2S, each submodel is meticulously designed to meet the specific demands of its operational environment. The naval versions often feature reinforced structures, corrosion-resistant materials, and specialized landing gear to handle the stress of carrier operations. Meanwhile, the Air Force versions optimize for performance factors like speed, range, and payload capacity, taking advantage of the stability and resources available at land-based airfields. GAP 2S. This dual approach allows both branches to leverage the core capabilities of these aircraft while ensuring they're fully equipped to handle their unique missions and environments. The operational doctrines of the Navy and Air Force translate into distinct mission profiles for their respective aircraft. Navy aircraft, primarily focused on maritime operations, are tasked with establishing naval superiority, projecting power ashore, and defending carrier strike groups from enemy threats. This requires a diverse fleet of aircraft, including fighters for air-to-air combat, attack aircraft for striking surface targets, and specialized aircraft for electronic warfare, reconnaissance, and anti-submarine warfare. The Air Force, with its broader mandate, employs aircraft for a wider range of missions, including air superiority, strategic bombing, close air support, and transportation. Air Force fighter jets are often designed for long-range interception and air dominance, while bomber aircraft are built to deliver heavy payloads over vast distances. The Air Force also operates a large fleet of transport aircraft, responsible for moving troops, supplies, and equipment around the globe. These differing mission profiles influence the design and capabilities of Navy and Air Force aircraft. Navy fighter jets, often tasked with defending the carrier strike group, prioritized maneuverability and short-range interception, while Air Force fighters focused on securing air superiority over a wider area may prioritize speed, range, and payload capacity. GAP-3S. Can a land force aircraft land on an aircraft carrier? Generally, land force aircraft are not designed to land on aircraft carriers due to the differences in landing gear, structural integrity, and arrestor hook requirements. If a land force aircraft attempts to land on an aircraft carrier, it may face significant challenges and potential damage. This could lead to a decrease in operational continuity and increased maintenance requirements. GAP-2S. The primary reason lies in the unique design specifications of aircraft carrier operations. Carrier-based aircraft are equipped with heavily reinforced landing gear capable of withstanding the impact forces of arrested landings, where the aircraft is rapidly decelerated by catching an arrestor wire on the deck. In contrast, land force aircraft designed for conventional runways lack the necessary structural reinforcements and arrestor hooks to safely engage with the carrier's landing system. GAP-2S. Additionally, the compact and rugged design of carrier-based aircraft allows them to handle the demanding environment of the carrier deck, which includes catapult launches and the corrosive effects of a maritime climate. Land force aircraft, optimized for different operational needs, may not endure these conditions without significant modifications. GAP-2S. In summary, while theoretically possible, landing a land force aircraft on an aircraft carrier is fraught with risks and challenges, making it an impractical solution without extensive alterations to the aircraft's design. A GAP-2S. The marine environment presents a unique set of challenges for naval aircraft. Constant waves and vibrations from the sea create a harsh and dynamic operating environment. GAP-2S. Unlike their Air Force counterparts, naval aircraft must be designed to withstand these relentless forces. GAP-2S. The vibrations and impact forces from the carrier deck can cause significant wear and tear on aircraft components. GAP-2S. This necessitates more frequent maintenance and inspection cycles to ensure operational readiness. GAP-2S. Naval aircraft are engineered with reinforced structures and specialized materials to endure the corrosive effects of saltwater and humid sea air. GAP-2S. Corrosion-resistant coatings and materials are critical in preventing rust and degradation. GAP-2S. Additionally, the design of naval aircraft often incorporates features like foldable wings to maximize space on the carrier deck. GAP-2S. These features, while beneficial, add complexity to the aircraft's design and maintenance requirements. GAP-2S. In contrast, Air Force aircraft operate in more stable environments, allowing for lighter and less rugged designs. GAP-2S. The absence of constant waves and vibrations means that Air Force aircraft can prioritize other performance factors such as speed, range, and payload capacity. GAP-2S. However, this also means that Air Force aircraft are not equipped to handle the stresses of carrier operations without significant modifications. GAP-2S. The rigorous demands of the marine environment shape every aspect of naval aircraft design, from structural integrity to material selection and maintenance protocols. GAP-2S. These adaptations ensure that naval aircraft remain mission capable in one of the most challenging operating environments on Earth. The unique operational environments and mission profiles of the Navy and Air Force have led to distinct design philosophies for their aircraft. Navy aircraft designed for carrier operations must be compact, lightweight, and incredibly robust to withstand the stresses of catapult launches and arrested landings. Folding wings, a common feature on Navy aircraft, allow for more aircraft to be stored on the limited space of a carrier deck. Air Force aircraft, unconstrained by the limitations of carrier operations, can be larger, heavier, and optimized for specific mission requirements. Air Force fighter jets, for example, may sacrifice some maneuverability for increased range, payload capacity, and advanced sensor suites. Bomber aircraft designed for long-range strikes are typically massive platforms capable of carrying a devastating array of ordnance. One of the most noticeable differences between Navy and Air Force aircraft is the design of their landing gear. Navy aircraft, subjected to the violent forces of arrested landings, have heavily reinforced landing gear systems with robust shock absorbers. The nose gear of a Navy aircraft is also typically equipped with a launch bar, a structural element that engages the catapult system for launch. Air Force aircraft landing on conventional runways have lighter and more conventional landing gear systems.